let's talk about how radiometric dating works. Only igneous rocks can be dated this way. That's a rock that was formed as a result of cooling lava or magma. When the molten material cools and becomes solid rock, that's when the radiometric clock starts. The rock will encapsulate something that is radioactive, and over time, the radioactive element decays into something stable. To get a date for the rock, the amount of the radioactive parent product and the amount of the stable daughter product are both measured, and then the age is calculated.
That's right. Now, note that scientists don't observe and measure the age of a rock. They observe and measure isotopes in the rock, and the isotope concentrations can be measured very accurately. That's not the issue, but isotope concentrations aren't dates. We have microscopes, we have telescopes, we don't have pastoscopes, right? That's not how it works.
So with that explanation, it might be a little easier for you to see where the assumptions are, right?
Hopefully, yeah. As we said, all dating methods involve making assumptions. You can't get around them. We can illustrate the assumptions involved in radiometric dating using an hourglass, where the radioactive parent isotope is the sand in the top, and over time it becomes the stable daughter isotope represented by the sand in the bottom.
Right. There are three main assumptions here. Number one, the starting conditions are known. For example, that there was no daughter isotope present at the start, or that we know how much was there. Number two, nuclear decay rates have always been constant. And number three, systems were closed or isolated so that no parent or daughter isotopes were lost or added.
Right. Now, all three of those assumptions cause huge errors in the dates. And we'll get to some examples of where the dates were way off in a few minutes.